Okay, I'm back with a new video, and I think we all had moments in life where we were ready to give up, and we felt lonely and abandoned and without hope, and we were, you know, going crazy, and we were so filled with pain that even running into a brick wall wouldn't solve the problem. But I think most of us got through it, not just once, but a couple of times, and you know, that's life. It's a bitch sometimes, can be a bitch, but it's still worth living. But what I wanted to talk to you about today is when you have the feeling of being abandoned by the gods or God. Now, there's somebody on this channel who is in a position right now, but he is being super dramatic about it. And when you're in that situation, I understand that, you know, painful and it's difficult. But if you use a little bit of logic and reason, then it should be okay, and you should be able to handle it. And being abandoned by the gods, or being abandoned by God, is something that belongs in a Christian state of mind, I think, where you have Jesus who is abandoned and alone, and he calls to his God and calls him Father. Why did you abandon me? Why did you leave me? Why did you leave me alone? Why did you forsake me? And he finally gave up and surrendered to the will of his Father, who then puts him on the cross. And but if you look at the Christian way of worshipping, then you find Jesus in the arms of his mother, who is breastfeeding him and cradling him and nurturing him. And even when he dropped down off the cross, or when they took him down off the cross, she's still, you know, holding him, and he is like completely powerless and without any type of self-control. And also, there is in Christianity, in the Christian faith, a lot of symbolism going on, where God is the Father and you are the child, and he's holding your hands and walks you through life, and he is there always and forever and permanently, and he cannot abandon you. And even when you forget him, he cannot forget you, and he is always there. And if you are stuck in a mind state that says, I am abandoned, I am lonely, nobody wants to help me, nobody wants to be with you, then please turn to Christianity and start praying to the Christian God. If you want to be pampered and breastfed, and if you want somebody to hold your hand all the time. But if you are in a more darker corner of faith, let's call it darker, or let's call it satanic, or whatever, then I think you should be able to tap into your own inner power, your own true self, and deal with life without the permanent, ongoing, forever assistance of your chosen ones. Call them gods or demons or whatever. Because maybe they have something better to do. They have better things to attend to, or there is somebody that needs them more than you. And then it would be totally egocentric and egoistic to, you know, start whining that you're left alone, and you're begging and praying for their presence and help and guidance and protection. I think all these gods we work with are more connected and in tune with nature. So instead of looking at a mom constantly breastfeeding her child, or a father holding the hand of his son or daughter, and is always there and never forgets you and guides you no matter what, I think it's best to, you know, have a more grown-up approach, a more grown-up adult state of mind, idea that, you know, sometimes you are fucking alone and life is a bitch and life is hard and difficult and cruel and you're going to have to go through it alone. So just to give you an image or a metaphor to work with, let's say you are a father bird and a mother bird, and you decide to, you know, have fun together, and you start building a nest, and the mom drops her eggs in it, and you know, they're flying back and forth, and you know, making it stronger and soft in the inside and strong on the outside, and the eggs are there and mom is sitting on them, and before you know it, the eggs break, they hatch, and 5 little birds come out, and these birds know that it's important to scream hard, because the one that screams the hardest is most likely to get fed. It's not like the father bird or the mother bird are, you know, flying in and out and they're like, does everybody have enough? No, they are going to feed the one who screams the hardest and is the most intense, and this one will grow bigger and stronger than the other ones, and that's the way it is. So does it mean that you have to scream your lungs out to get attention from mom and dad? No, it just means that you have to feed when it's time to eat, when it's time to eat, and eat when you are being fed, and then it's important to grow up as quickly as possible. What happens to the weak ones? They either die because of starvation, or they die because the big sister or brother kicks you out of the nest before you can even fly. And maybe 3 of them remain, and then they start training their wings. They start to gain muscle and become stronger and stronger and get ready to fly out of the nest. Now, what happens to the weak ones? They starve or get thrown out of the nest. What happens to the one that's arrogant and a smartass and, you know, he tries to fly before he is strong enough? He is going to stand on the side of the nest and he's going to spread his wings and be, you know, all cool and, you know, arrogant about it. And then he starts to fly and jump, and maybe he makes it before he hits the ground, or maybe not. And what happens to the arrogant piece of shit that begins to fly before he's ready? He crashes into the ground. And mom and dad might or might not look down and think, well, he's dead or not. And if you're not dead by the time you hit your head against the wall or on the ground, then they're not going to pick you up. It's either you fly, even though it's before your time, or you fly when you hit the ground, because else you get eaten. Mom and dad are not going to pick you up and help you back into the nest, you know, to give you a second chance. No. So it's important that you eat when you get fat, that you charge and recharge and reboot when the power is given to you, If you don't, then, you know, you die. Another thing is when you get fat and you eat, you train your muscles and you stand on the edge and there you go, you fly. You leave your parents alone. You leave them. You fly away. You're not coming back. You know, you grew up in that nest and then you fly away as far from your parents as possible. So you forget the ones that fed you and you are going to live your own life. I think that's me because I personally forget about my gods a lot because normal life catches up with me. But bird number three. The first two already died because they didn't scream enough and, you know, they didn't eat when they get fed or didn't fight for what they deserved and, you know, so they already died. One crashed into the ground, two flies away, and three, or number five, is being lazy. And he sits in a nest and he, you know, makes his parents come in and out of the nest with food, and at some point mom and dad are going to think this is one fat ugly motherfucker. What are we going to do with him? We're going to kick him out. He didn't practice his wings, he didn't train muscle, he's just going chubby and lazy and spoiled, rotten and being nasty and arrogant and whining and needy and clingy, and he demands food where he's far beyond his time, and mom and dad are like, go. They start picking him and pushing him, and he just, you know, goes over the edge, and he either flies or he dies. That's it. Another option is that mom and dad are like, well, the weather is beautiful, we are ready for a second nest, and they didn't start picking you or pushing you or throwing you out of the nest, or they just abandon you. They fucking leave. They are like, that fat, ugly motherfucker, you know, he is lost, he is completely lost and we're off. And they're not going to say goodbye, or, you know, they're not going to motivate you. They're not going to be, you know, encouraging, like, it's time for you to fly. Just please try a little bit, you know, please try a little. They're just going to leave, you know, and start another nest. If you're too heavy, if you're too heavy of a burden to, you know, throw you over the edge, they are just going to fly away and start another nest and do their thing there. So if you are interested in whining and being clingy and wanting to be supported all the time, then please go to, you know, God and accept Jesus as your savior and start praying and, you know. But remember that even Jesus was abandoned by his father. Well, not really abandoned, but I think that Jesus was like, I don't want this, I don't want this thing from happening, and I don't want to die on the cross. And then he surrendered to the will of his father. And his father was like, yeah, that's what I want for you, to die on the cross, you know? Great idea. I don't know, but I think either way, it's normal that the gods or God abandons you at some point. And if I would have been Jesus, I would have said, well, fuck you, Father. That's not what I want. I love you dearly, but I am, you know, bye. But I'm not Jesus, so he died on the cross. Anyway, besides the fact that being alone and deserted and struggling through life all on your own is hell, can be hell, if you have any dignity inside of you, any power, any confidence, then you know that you will get through whatever happens. A robbery, a beating, a rape, an attack, whatever, financial disaster, disease, anything. And you can't expect the gods to be with you all the time. I think that's retarded. I think that's stupid. I think that's childish. And my personal problem is, like I said before, or a little bit earlier, is that I often forget the gods that I work with. And I'm not very proud of it, but it's just like, you know, I'm doing my thing. I'm cooking, I'm gardening, I'm playing around with my dog. I'm taking a nap, I'm watching TV, and they're tapping on my shoulder all the time. Hello, hello. It's them that, you know, don't want me, you know, to forget about them. So I don't know what's worse, but it's the same with the bird that, you know, gets fed, gets stronger, starts training, stands on the edge, and, you know, flies away and leaves his parents alone. And the parents are like, proud, you know, they're not insulted or, you know, they're not hurt. They are just, you know, we did a good job. She's flying. That doesn't mean that they're angry with the ones that were stupid enough to start flying before they could, or they are angry with the one that's, you know, clinging and kneeling and whining and start to get fatter and fatter and spoil them. They just leave him behind and that's that. So look at this as something pure and more raw and more realistic and earthy and worldly than the image that you get presented by a lot of faiths. I just named Christianity because the imagery is beautiful, you know, baby Jesus cradled, held by the mom, Mother Mary. You know, even when he died, she was still holding him. Or the father holding a child, you know, and guiding it. And I don't think that works for a lot of Satanists. And if you can't deal with loneliness and you can't tap into your own power, you're a lost bird, I think. Either you start flying or you die. That's it. Of course, there are other reasons that you feel that when you feel abandoned by the gods is that you don't feel them. That doesn't mean that they aren't there. Or maybe they aren't there, but they will come back. It's all about faith and attraction. If you radiate the wrong energy, you attract other gods. If you radiate a certain energy that says, I'm alone and lonely, I can't do it myself, then I think, I don't know what kind of energy you will attract. But again, a lot of fake spirits or lower spirits or, you know, but if you feel empowered, even though you are going through a rough time and you can handle being abandoned and you can handle being lonely and you still have that inner spark to tap into, you know, that attracts a lot of like-minded spirits that are the same and feeling the same and have a similar idea or vibe. Your vibe attracts your tribe, so choose wisely. And if you start whining and keep complaining and never be able to do it alone, then, you know, I don't know. Let me know in the comments what you guys think. Maybe there are other options that I missed. See you next time. Bye.